She was asking me why didn't I counter what Barry said. Why did you tell me you fucked Tega 2 days ago?
Did anybody fuck anybody?
Did we have sex?
As in.
Hi!
Okay, I'm like, you're paying so much attention to your viewers. You don't even know if your actions are even boring.
So, this is what I do not exactly understand. We all saw the video. I mean, guys, it was on Showmax. We saw that video. We saw every single detail. I don't even have to go ahead to describe to you all the positions, the different details of what exactly Boma and Tega did. Guys, they went from kissing, they went to touching beneath the sheets. And then the next thing we saw was Tega's leg, her right leg specifically, positioned on Boma's waist, right? Now, what does that mean? It means that there was an opening in between her legs. And then who knows what happened next? But the next thing we saw was some thrustings. Yes, some thrustings, movement of thrustings. And then afterwards, we saw Boma reaching out to grab the tissue beside the bed. And guys, the tissue looks like it had been used regularly. I don't know, because they've been spending the night on the same bed for some days now. So that was exactly what we saw on that video. And so guys, these people are coming out to come and explain that nothing, or claim that nothing happened. Guys, I feel so insulted. I feel like I am blind even when my two eyes can see clearly. I mean, God, it's as though they are aware that by now the public would have been talking about it. It's as if they are aware that people would want to know what happened to the truth. And so they decided to take the opportunity to try to do damage control, to try to debunk the conversation, the rumors, you know, that it actually did happen. I mean, it's okay for them to actually have conversations about it. And I would have given them more respect if they had kind of owned up to what they did. But no, instead, they're trying to make the viewers look stupid. They're trying to make it look as though the viewers are all blind. Because look at what they were saying.
She's kind of scared that just in case anything happens, and you might now want to tell Perry, because you and Perry are...
Okay, I'm not even close like that.
I'm like...
And then when they were asking each other, like, did anything happen? Did anything happen? I'm like, oh my God, this is the biggest mistake that these two people have made, that like they've just successfully shot themselves in the leg. The last thing you want to do as a Big Brother Naija housemate is having done something that the whole world has seen glaringly, and then you're trying to treat the whole world like they are blind dogs, like they cannot see, like their eyes are completely shut. That was exactly what Boma and Tega successfully did this afternoon. And guys, trust me, if one of them or both of them did not go home this week or next week, then trust me, they're not going to win the show, hands down. Hey guys, you're welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Glory Elijah, and this is Frankly Speaking with Glory. I am the girl with the tea. And on this video, I've already started talking about what I want to talk about anyways, yes? So, simply put, it's all about Boma and Tega trying to debunk or just blatantly denying every single thing that we saw on their sexcapade video. And guys, I don't know, but you know what, just watch to the end of this video, because they had other kinds of conversation, you know, together with that particular conversation. I'm going to be spilling all of it on this particular video, so please make sure you watch to the end. And if you are new to my channel, you are absolutely welcome. If you are a returning subscriber, I love you so much for coming back. Thank you so much. Listen guys, if you are yet to turn on post notifications, you need to do that definitely, because that's the best way for you to always receive a lot of my videos. I upload videos multiple times daily, so you totally don't want to miss out on any single detail of the ongoings in the current Big Brother Naija show. Alright, aside from Big Brother Naija, I talk about so many other things. I do movie reviews, I talk about social issues, trending topics. So if you're looking for a place to get the juiciest and most factual and analytical commentaries about all of those things, yes, this is the right place to be. Alright, so let's get into this video quickly. So what even started this conversation between Boma and Tega again was Tega was just basically reporting Queen to Boma. Oh God. And guys, that just made me realize that it's not by getting married, it's not by having a child, it's about maturity, you know? Being a wife and a mother, it doesn't really make people 100% smart, to be very honest. I actually thought that Tega was actually a very, very smart person. But then, having to report Queen to Boma based on the fact that, oh, yesterday, Queen was talking to her about not reacting to what Pere had said, it just made me realize that, okay, this lady is completely unsmart. She's not smart at all. And it was just so painfully sad that she's not really smart. Or she probably knows what she's doing, you know, just basically trying to paint Queen as the bad person and then redeem her already tarnished image outside the house. Guys, because I don't understand. So yesterday, basically, I already did a video about that of Queen, you know, advising her that next time when they are playing a game like that and Pere says something like that, she should immediately, you know, clear the air, debunk whatever Pere is saying, because Pere is an instigator in the house. And everybody knows that Pere has a reputation of using your secret against you, especially when they are playing games. And guys, this is one thing that Tega is fully aware of. As a matter of fact, she's fully aware of this same Boma that is doing shady things with Beneath the Duvet is also a kiss and tell kind of guy. Tega fully knows all of these things. So when Queen was advising her yesterday, guys, I was applauding Queen because it wasn't out of place for Queen to do so, because Tega has always stood as a mediator in all the issues that Queen had in the house. Tega has always been the one person that is always advising everybody in the house because she feels like she knows it all. So yesterday, Queen advising Tega, guys, for me, I felt like that was commendable. Just as expected, Boma started bashing Queen. That don't mind, that it's because of what had happened before. I do not owe anybody an apology, blah, 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 blah.
I didn't even know if anybody discusses that kind of shit in the house, man.
So when she said that thing, I was like, no, you broke the code of conduct. Because, first off, the fact that he told you that is because he wanted you to have closure.
And guys, I don't know how many of you have noticed, yeah? Boma has this self-righteous personality that when he is wrong, he would argue and argue and argue and be very, very defensive. He would definitely argue his way out of that situation. And then later, when he goes into the diary room, not just even in the diary room, when he's having a conversation with a fellow housemate, he tries to do some stupid PR for himself, clean his image, always trying to tell people that, oh, this is who I am, I'm a peacemaker. When I know that I am wrong, I definitely apologize. I mean, there are so many times that I have done things before that I wasn't at fault, but I have apologized. And guys, this guy, whatever he's doing, whenever he does that, anybody that has never been watching Big Brother Naija before and they just stumble on that particular, you know, scene of him explaining himself and portraying himself to be a saint, people like that might think that, oh, this guy is actually a nice person. So Boma is very strategic when he does that. He does that at every point in time, especially when he notices that the camera is on him. And so that was the exact same thing he was doing. I mean, anybody that knows about the Boma and Queen situation, they would know that Boma was at fault. He led her on. He took Queen for a ride, used that to catch crews at the expense of her naivety or ignorance, because at that time, she was actually new in the house. So she didn't really understand what was going on, which ships existed, which relationship or situationships existed in the house. And guys, yes, Queen had her own fault by not putting her body in one place, but always jumping from one man to another. But yes, Boma did what he did. Guys, in that situation, Boma was wrong. Boma was supposed to apologize to Queen. But till today, he refused to. He even said it in his conversation with Tega.
It's been nothing to you. That's why Mazi now saying, I don't know why Mazi is like, yo, you have to talk about you, Mazi, fuck this shit, man. Like, I'm not dealing.
That white money has been telling him, Jepa has been telling him, go and talk to this girl, settle whatever differences you have with this girl. But he has blatantly refused. And then he had the guts to open his mouth and be saying that, the kind of person he is, he's a peacemaker, he apologizes even when he's wrong. Like, Boma, just shut up. Please, just shut up. Whilst both of them were having that conversation, guys, I was just basically studying their body language. And it was very obvious that these two people, they were putting all of their energy into concealing what they had done. I mean, guys, you could look, when you look at Boma's facial expression, you will see that he's sending some subliminal signals to Tega not to mention what they actually did. And Tega was playing along because she was wearing shades. In my head, I was thinking, why didn't you remove your shades while having that conversation? Let's see into your eyes and know if you're lying or not. I mean, we'll definitely find out. Yeah, because Tega was wearing shades and both of them, they maintained eye contact and they were continuously telling each other who did it, who had sex. Nothing happened. What happened? What did they say happened? I mean, guys, come on. See, the worst thing that any housemate can do is to make the viewers look stupid, and that was what Boma and Tega did. I mean, come on, give us some credit. We're not dumb, we're not that dumb. Even though some of us might come across as dumb, not all of us are dumb, we're not that dumb. I mean, guys, their body language said it all, that they were lying, obviously, because much later, no, not long afterwards, Big Brother called for all the housemates to stay in the garden and lock the main house doors. The moment all the housemates were flooding in, there were a flurry of activities here and there, a lot of noise, and then immediately Boma moved over to Tega's side of the bed, and then they were talking in hushed tones, they were whispering. And from the things they were saying, guys, it was just very obvious that these people, they are guilty. So they took out that time, knowing fully well that the camera was on them, they took out that time to try and clear their name, clear the air, make it look as if nothing actually happened. Now guys, when they were constantly saying nothing happened, I'm like, okay, fine, no. Since people think you are bold enough to open your mouth and own up to your shit, why didn't you just say, okay, oh, this is what we actually did exactly? Yeah, I mean, because Tega keeps trying to make it look as though she doesn't actually care what people think or what anybody outside in the real world thinks about what her husband would think. So if you're not scared, if you don't give a damn, why didn't they just open their mouth and clearly explain that scenario to us? Anyways, guys, I just thought I should let you all know that this is what is going on in the house. I mean, these two people, they obviously have an agenda. And in their mind, they feel like it's actually working. What they do not understand is it's actually adding fuel to the fire, actually infuriating the viewers more. But I would love to know your thoughts about this one, guys. So please just go ahead and let me know what you think about their conversation in the comment section below. And I'll see you on another episode of Frankly Speaking with Gloria Elijah shortly. Don't go anywhere. Bye.